Hello everyone, welcome to NP News Network. Today we are at a very special place, and if you are a bird lover, you must watch this video till the end. No guys, we are not at aviary or something. This is a house from the city's most crowded area, which is Sinhagad Road. And yet, what you saw is real. We have Utkarsha Vitekar with us, who has made this impossible thing possible. And so Utkarsha, tell us, how did you make this possible?
Okay, so as we all know, sparrows, which are getting extinct these days, right? So basically, you know, I've always had this affinity towards sparrows, birds and animals. So I think around 4-5 years back in my college days, there was an NGO, Seva Sparrows, who were distributing these bird feeders. So it was a new concept. So what was a bird feeder? Nobody knew. But they were like, you know, this is something we've introduced, and sparrows will multiply within no time. So then after waiting in the queue for almost an hour or so, I finally could get it, and yes, the results are here. So
tell me, like, how many kinds of birds and other animals come here? Like,
okay, so we have like 20-30 sparrows coming over.
Okay.
Yeah, and mostly during monsoon, you'll see munias, white-scaled munias is what we call them. And then we have these weaver birds, which are yellow. I mean, both the male and female, they come in couples.
Okay.
So yeah, in pairs, they'll just come over and enjoy. I mean, in fact, even now they do visit us most of the times. Then we have parrots, and yes, we have squirrels. So
despite being squirrel being not that familiar with mankind, so how do you manage that?
Okay, so you know, despite being the third floor here, you can see those gas pipelines outside. They'll climb them up from the garden and they'll come over. And then the net part, they'll go and stick onto it and they'll go and have that bird feeder feed which is available there. So it's something like now they've familiarized with us, so they are pretty okay with it. And yeah, I mean, they like being around us.
Thank you. when you are not here, like you are out of town or something like that, so how do you take care of them? Do you miss them or do they miss you back? Like, what is
so it is both ways, I would say. Yes, definitely we do miss them, and so they do. But since we don't want them to starve out of hunger, we just ensure that the bird feeders are full. We fill it up, refill it completely, and we make sure, you know, the water, there are some small pots that we have put in for water and bowls for food. So we just make extra arrangements, ensuring that that is sufficient for the time period we are not available here.
So you have made a lot of handmade things for them, like you have made containers out of coconut. So how do you do that? Like,
so actually my grandmother, she does all this DIY things.
Okay.
And so just to make sure, you know, they have enough space and comfort zone for them, she, you know, gets all these coconuts and then she, you know, I don't know, she just does it all and then she installs it there. And I would like to mention the old buckets that we have, which we throw away, literally the plastic buckets. She got the ring out of it and then she's installed it there. So, you know, you can see the sparrows and other, I mean, even squirrels go and sit down out there.
It's like
and
a bench for them.
Kind of a bench, yes. Additional space.
Okay. So that's a really creative thing you have done. And in a city like Pune where sparrows are getting, like, we only see in pictures right now. So it's a really noble thought you have given. And thank you so much.
Thank you.